Could a person-centered approach, which had worked before with groups containing hostile factions, could it work with a group at this level, a group where many of them knew nothing about this kind of an approach, knew nothing of the way we worked, and had had very little information before they came as to what they were facing? I'd like to speak first of Rust, Austria, where the workshop of influential leaders from leaders of political action and leaders of thought met in a workshop. It was symbolic that we met in Rust because that faces a salty lake, and across the lake is Hungary. You look across the lake through the Iron Curtain to Hungary on the other side. And Austria and Hungary have managed to maintain good relationships in spite of many, many obstacles. So it was a nice symbol of the fact that diverse peoples can live together, meet together, work together. And then the hotel in which we stayed was also important to us. Dr. Karl Vach, who was head of one of the largest banks in Vienna, more than a year ago, offered us the use of this hotel and said that the bank would pay the expenses of the workshop during the 4 days. We all thought at that time there would be about 30 people. As it worked out, there were double that number. The workshop was sponsored by the Center for Studies of the Person, and it was also sponsored by the United Nations University for Peace in Costa Rica, and Rodrigo Carazzo and Murray Silberman of that group were very important in getting together high-level people from Central America and Latin America. Then at our end of the project, Gay Swenson was the co-director of the La Jolla end of the project, and the workshop wouldn't possibly have been put on were it not for her efforts. And all of us worked hard on it. There were 50 participants, and it was a distinguished group. There were three ex-presidents of Central American countries, the current vice president of Costa Rica. There were three or four from ministries of foreign affairs, including the Ministry of Foreign Affairs for Austria, who visited formally to give the workshop his blessing. Then there were, I think, seven ambassadors, seven or eight legislators. Anyway, it was from various countries. There was a theme for the workshop, the Central American challenge. That's what accounts for the fact that a lot of the high status people came from the Central and Latin American countries, and that proved to be a very, very good thing. The question facing all of us was, could a person-centered approach, which had worked before with groups containing hostile factions, could it work with a group at this level, a group where many of them knew nothing about this kind of an approach, knew nothing of the way we worked, and had had very little information before they came as to what they were facing? We had tried to give many of them information, but some of them were last-minute changes, so that a lot of them really came with almost no information about what to expect. And especially, could we handle the kind of feelings that might exist between the United States, people from the United States and from Nicaragua and El Salvador and so on. The staff met before and during and after the workshop. And the closeness of the staff was a very important feature of the workshop itself. During the workshop, we met twice a day at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock in the morning, and again after the finish of the small groups. We decided there would be general meetings in the morning and four small groups in the afternoon. And the small groups were carefully selected to be as much a cross-section of the whole workshop as possible, so that people from Central America and the U.S. and so on, and the other countries, were distributed through each of the groups. Men and women were evenly distributed so far as possible. The small groups were representative. In the general sessions, which met in the morning, we were determined that there would be a minimum of protocol, and I think we pretty well held to that. When it came to introducing the director of the bank that was subsidizing the thing, we had to be a little bit formal. And when the Austrian foreign minister breezed in with the cameras flashing and so on, we had to admit that we had a notable person in our presence. But by and large, we worked on a first name basis, which was very important. I saw only the general sessions. I was not privileged to be in the small groups, and that's what I want the staff to contribute. But I'll say one or two words about the general session. The first general session started off with a few introductory remarks by me. Then an Austrian diplomat spoke up for a few minutes. Then a young American conservative challenged the Nicaraguan representative, the ambassador, saying, why is your country shut off human rights? Why have they introduced censorship of the press and so on? And that was quite a tense moment. The Nicaraguan handled it very well. He said, I can't answer that question without giving you a lot of background information. And he gave a lot of well-organized information about his country. Then the discussion was pulled away from that. It's interesting to see the wisdom of the group, because they realized we were not quite ready to handle that kind of confrontation within 3 minutes after the conference started. It was followed, really, by what I would call a lot of presentations. Different members gave good presentations, often, about their country or about the Contadoras, about different elements of the situation in Central America. But they were presentations. No one listened to one another. It was just a matter of waiting to see when can I get in and give my speech. And I remember feeling very strongly and in a somewhat resigned fashion, I might have to listen to this sort of thing through the whole 4 days. It may be that that's where this group is. But I felt a deep trust in the group process that I've seen so many times, and I felt that, okay, if I have to live with this kind of thing, if this is where they are, if this is where they're going to stay, I'll live with it, I'll accept it. And they didn't stay at that level. I think that it was the patient trust in the group process which really got the workshop off to its start. Some people, especially Americans who knew something about our work, were complaining by the second day, but we aren't seeing a demonstration of the person-centered procedures. We aren't seeing, Carl isn't demonstrating a person-centered technique and so on. No, and they didn't see much of that through the whole workshop, because somehow the groups almost facilitated themselves. What they did see was a person-centered way, they didn't necessarily see it. What they might have experienced, and which some of them did experience, was a person-centered way of being, and that seemed to make a pretty profound difference.